Sup guys, Carlos here. Welcome to the second and last part of the No More Heroes Iceberg, where we'll be looking at the four Iceberg levels left with the most mysterious and dark facts about our favorite Eltaku assassin and his friends. Before you continue watching this video, if you haven't watched the first part yet, I highly recommend you to do so. The previous video had many facts that a lot of people might don't know, in case you're wondering why I won't mention a fact that you already know. The video will work the same as the previous one, by the way. However, before I continue with the video, I'm going to correct two mistakes I made in the previous video. The first one being No More Heroes 1.5. In the video, I said the only way to watch it is with Japanese dubs, because it was a DVD release only in Japan. You wanna know something funny? The day before I upload the first part, Grasshopper Manufacture upload to Euro an English dub for No More Heroes 1.5, invalidating what I said in the video in the process, but I still put the English dub in the description with the respective explanation. And the other mistake I made was not saying Dan Smith's motive to kill Batman. Batman sold Dan Smith and Christopher Mills to Killer 7's bad guys to run away and gain more time to find his daughter's killer. Now, with my mistakes corrected, I can continue with the video with no more delays. Let's go to deeper waters.
What's a kid doing here?
I'm born to kill you.
No More Heroes Toilet Paper. Yup, 2006. During the No More Heroes Japanese launch, Suda51 and Yasuhiro Wada gave them away toilet papers with No More Heroes picture to everyone who bought the game in Akihabara Soft Map Amusement. This also applied to No More Heroes 2 with another thematic toilet paper, but to obtain this one you had to pre-order a Japanese copy of the game. Santa Destroys Awkward Era. Am I the only one who feels uncomfortable during a wall in No More Heroes 1 Santa Destroys City? I don't know how to describe this feeling, but every time I walk around in the city, I'm starting to feel empty. Like the fucking city! Quinton Flynn's accusation. Quinton Flynn is Henry's original voice. Back in November 2020, he was accused for sexual harassment and grooming minors, although those accusations were false, verified by a judge. Even with Quinton being innocent all this time, he was scrapped to retake Henry's voice in No More Heroes 3. What a shame. I really miss his Irish accent. Sylvia had a OnlyFans. In their More Losers manga, after Travis killed Helter Skelter, Vincent met with a Scandinavian girl even after his big brother's warning to not approach to her. That girl is called Sylvia Crystal, who was working as a call girl. Maybe this is her actual job alongside scamming pervert otaku fans who of nearly naked underage anime girls. No More Heroes Outer Rim Remix. The Outer Rim is an album by the band of the same name. In the tracks 1 and 5, you can listen to a conversation between Travis and Sylvia.
Happy birthday, my darling.
Merci. You truly are the love of my life.
Hard to believe it's been 120 years since we tied the knot, and 76 years since we rode the shuttle into outer space.
It is revealed in the first track that the two married and subsequently traveled into space, and also, somehow, they became immortal. This could have been a decent ending for No More Heroes 3, but we end up getting another cliffhanger ending. Mr. Wormhole. Mr. Wormhole is Mr. Black Hole's big brother. He appeared for the first time in Travis Strikes Back's last chapter alongside Black Hole. Both were a sneak peek for the future plot of No More Heroes 3, but no one knows why Mr. Wormhole didn't appear in No More Heroes 3. I wonder what happened to him. Canceled No More Heroes TV series. During an interview with IGN, Suda51 mentioned that he tried to bring Travis to the big screen with a movie or a TV series, but no one of those offers has come to fruition. Maybe we'll see a No More Heroes live action movie someday, but for now, we will have to wait. Holly Summer's grave in No More Heroes 3. If you go to the beach in No More Heroes 3, you will find 3 live boys at the end of it. Now, if you watch the cutscene where Travis buried the body of Holly Summers, you will notice that he does it in the same place where the live boys are in the future. It may be a coincidence, but I really doubt that it's just a coincidence. Unused No More Heroes 1 area. No More Heroes 1 only has one place in the entire map where the camera perspective is different. Perhaps a unique event could have taken place here, but nobody knows what was the purpose of this place during development phase. The Chronicles of Travis Touchdown. It is a shitpost series made by Nate Neck. If I had a word to describe this series, would be... I don't really know. Travis hates everyone who used the N-word. He killed Peter Griffin and become friends with Dante the Snake. What the fuck am I even saying? Bishop was killed because of Travis' fault. Think about it. Travis killed Jasper Bats Jr.'s family. As a result, he hired the Mafia to take over the city and kill Bishop in the process. If Travis hadn't taken the job to stop Pizza Bat bosses, Bishop might be still alive. Matt Helm's backstory. Matt Helm is a boss of No More Heroes 2. He was abandoned by his parents to let him die, and when he was about to die in a house fire, he made a pact with the devil to come back to life and to kill his parents. When Travis defeats him, he takes the form of a little child to let Travis drop his guard. Sylvia arrives to rescue him and her team burns the house. Yet, Matt cannot die. Just look at the window. His soul will never rest in peace. Sonic Youth's uncensored dialogue. Before fighting Sonic Youth, Travis starts with him about how Final Fantasy VII is an overrated game that everyone loves but him, mentioning how the karate look fucking stupid because of Nomura's design.
Nope. Even if they remake it, I'm not going anywhere near FF7.
Why not? What reason could you have to be so stubborn about it?
Because the characters look fucking stupid!
Obviously, all mention to Nomura and Final Fantasy VII were censored to avoid getting sued by Square Enix. Slingshot Vocal Mix. Kelter Herte has two versions of his team, the first one being the one we all know, and the other is a vocal version produced by The Riot, Teens of Anger. Shinobu and Silverface dialogue. Destroyman design for No More Heroes 4. During a live stream hosted by IGN Japan, Suda51 revealed Destroyman and Kimi Howard's concept art. Also, he revealed another Destroyman concept art called Final Destroyman, which will appear in No More Heroes 4. Now, the question is, could Final Destroyman get real at this point? After all, Suda51 said No More Heroes 3 was Travis' last adventure directed by him. Only time knows the answer. No More Heroes World Ranker. World Ranker was a Japanese exclusive mobile game. You can personalize an avatar depending on your likes to battle in a gameplay that was basically a rock, paper, scissors game with No More Heroes elements like beam katanas, guns, and beam gauntlets. It was a game with a lot of pay-to-win elements. To become the best assassin in the game, you had to pay big amounts of your money. Gladi was cancelled 1 year later after its launch. Unfortunately, its cancellation was so unexpected that finding gameplay on Europe or other Japanese websites is almost impossible. The gameplay that you are watching right now is the only one I could find after hours of searching. I even tried to contact Grasshopper Manufacturer and Marvelous through my Facebook account to ask them about gameplay footage that they might have but never upload to YouTube, but I didn't receive any response from them. If any of my viewers belong to the Grasshopper Manufacturer team or know someone who is working there, please tell them to upload any No More Heroes World Ranker content they might have. Anything is crucial for a lost media game like this. Ellis and Margaret were sisters. Before fighting Ellis, you can see her burning a photo arrow. Unfortunately, you can see which photo she is burning in. However, diving into the game's code, you can find some pictures in low quality, confirming that Alice had a family before and probably was Margaret Moonlight's big sister. Batman is a Killer 7 character. Thanks to my friend Makers Melek for helping me with this one. Originally, Batman was supposed to be a character for Killer 7, but because of time issues, he couldn't be added to the game. That is why Suda51 wrote a novel called Killer is Dead, featuring him as the protagonist, but instead of being called Batman, it was called The Bat, Shinobu rematch in No More Heroes 1. If you search through the game's data, you will find some tracks of the game with different names. For example, Jin's team was originally for Destroyman fight, and Holy Summer's team was named Shinobu 2, revealing that Shinobu was planned to have two boss fights early in development. Fu has three songs. Everyone who finished No More Heroes 3 knows that Fu has two faces, one where he becomes into a beast with no arm to control, and the other when he becomes into that giant head. A very disappointing fight, by the way. But did you know that Fu originally had another battle team for his first phase? Instead of being Grave Digger, it was this one. This team was in the version 1.0 of the game until the update 1.0.2, where this team was assigned to Midori Midorikawa's fight. Jin's gender change. Okay, I'm not sure where did I get this one, but it leaves me a bit confused. Since the first game, I thought Jin was a female, but in No More Heroes 3, we found out she has a very masculine voice. For a few seconds, I really thought she was in fact a male, but after thinking about it, she's just a female cat with a very dense voice. Beam katanas are not based on Star Wars. Believe it or not, contrary to popular belief, the beam katanas are not based on the lightsaber from Star Wars, but from the 1980s Japanese TV series Space Sheriff Gavan and 1987 film Spaceballs.
There was someone standing behind my father and mother. That person killed my parents.
Every copy of Normal Heroes is personalized. We all know the meme at this point. Every video game Iceberg has to have its own personalized copy with obscure, unusual, or creepy stories to scare the people of the internet. Nevertheless, since I became a fan of this franchise, I've been reading different stories or experiences about the first No More Heroes game, like weird glitches or crashes that caused the game to look very creepy. Not all of us had the same experience with this game, after all. Travis Tries Again was an experiment. What if Travis Tries Again was a different game on purpose? What if Suda knew the game would be a failure but didn't give a shit anyways? What if the game was an experiment to test how No More Heroes still keeps up with today's standards? We all know Travis Tries Again was a unique project with completely twist gameplay for No More Heroes standards. Everything in this game was an experiment that ended up with mixed reviews. Killer Marathon 2-1 and 3-1. Both are soundtracks of Killer Marathon Redux from Travis Tries Again, but these are not just two common soundtracks. Just listen and you will understand why. The other track has the same lyrics but in English instead.
Identification number 51,
The most unexpected aspect of both tracks is definitely how the composer used the Google text-to-speech service as the singer for the song. Without doubt, a creative way to create unique tracks. Jean's uncensored dialogue. Before the final fight against Travis' sister, she talks about her tragic past, but it was so cruel that she censored it by increasing the speech speed to unlistenable levels. However, by decreasing the speed levels, you can hear what she tried to censor.
Okay, I'll make it short and quick. You are my half-brother. You know that manga called Miyuki? The Japanese one? Well, it's like that. Your father abandoned my mother to run off with your mother. It broke her heart beyond repair. She killed herself. Knowing I had nowhere to go, he took advantage of me. Ever since I can remember, he molested me. We lived in this rotten apartment, and I was his slave. Every day I cursed his soul. I swore that I would kill him one day. But cursing didn't change anything. That's when I decided to become a killer. With no money to pay for training, I paid with my body. But to you, I bet that son of a bitch looked like a hard-working family man. That was all an act. He didn't give two shits about cleaning up my life. So I decided to clean it up myself. That's why I do what I do. And I got what I wanted. Killing him in front of your very eyes. That's my story.
Dr. Naomi's real age. There is a lot of information not present in the games that we might don't know until Zelda 51 reveals it in an interview. Like Dr. Naomi's age, in No More Heroes 1, she is 63 years old and 66 in No More Heroes 2. She uses technology and brains to keep her young. Travis can sell figure. Do not research. I literally just told my friend Touchdown's video for this fact. One day, he found out a website called Molecula A who had pre-orders open for a 1.6 careful articulate Travis figure. Years later, when he had the money to buy it, to his surprise, the page was shut down. And after some researching, he found out Molecular 8 was a massive scam. It seems we will still have to dream about more official No More Heroes merchandise, unfortunately. If you wanna know more details about this scam, the link of the video is in the description. Billy's mom. I'm sure you don't know this one. In an interview with IGN, Suda51 responds to a stupid but funny question. How Travis lost his virginity? He responds by saying Travis laid one of his friend's mothers after drinking too many beers at a party. Travis didn't lose his virginity with Sylvia after all. Even so, we don't know who is this mother. The only clue we know at this point is the photography in No More Heroes 2 with Billy's mom's words in it. Maybe she is the mom who robbed Travis' virginity. Why am I talking about the virginity of a video game character? What the fuck is wrong with my life? Captain Vladimir was a ghost. Captain Vladimir is one of the mysterious bosses in No More Heroes. He survived in space for years without any supplement, has supernatural powers like being able to teleport at his will, controlling gravity, and even his own Russian satellite. If you beat him, he will join his last breath at peace before turning into stardust. That is why I'm sure he was a ghost all this time. Tell me in the comments below what do you think about this theory. Naomi and Juvenal are sisters. Another fact confirmed by Suda but remains as a mystery in the games. In an interview that I couldn't find, Suda tells to his interviewers that Naomi is Juvenal's older sister. A large part of the fandom, including me, didn't notice until the intro of No More Heroes 3, where Juvenal awakens her big sister to activate Travis' full armor. Talbot's face. Talbot and Weller are Sylvia's companion in charge of cleaning the rest of the corpses after every ranking match from the first game to the last one. Talbot is the tall and silent guy. He is so tall that we haven't seen his face until this day, making him one of the most mysterious characters of the franchise by far. Destroyman spoiled Badger's insta-kill. Destroyman is a meme in the community. Just ask to any No More Heroes fan about his opinion about him and you will understand why Destroyman is the pinnacle of comedy. But when Destroyman teaches you something, he really teaches you something. During the cutscene before fighting him, Travis lowers his guard and shakes hands with him, causing him to be electrocuted by Destroyman's powers. Only with this cutscene, you learn something so important to every fight. You can't trust assassins. After this lesson, if you still end up getting caught by Bad Gear's insta-kill, congratulations, you are a simp. Patrick Granada Jr. Patrick Granada Jr. is Mr. Doppelganger's real name. He's a character from Travis Tries Again. He's a psychopath serial killer who kills people only for fun. By reading emails through Travis' computer, we find out that Doppelganger was based on the real assassin Patrick Granada Jr., who was also Dr. Juvenal's adoptive father before turning into a serial killer. New Destroyman Third Head. If you watch New Destroyman's execution just after cutting his head, another head appears out of nowhere. This is just a visual glitch, but it's so creepy. Destroyman is a cutie fan. His dialogue with Shinobu in No More Heroes 2 implies that he might have been a rapist and a professional Smash player when he worked as an assassin and mailman. The Let's Shake treatment. Do you know what I mean with the Let's Shake treatment? To all the bosses who didn't have the opportunity to fight Travis, every game has its own bosses with its painful treatment. In the first game, Let's Shake and Darkstar are the only two who couldn't face Travis because they were killed by someone else. No More Heroes 2 has the worst Let's Shake treatment of all the games. Do you wanna know how many bosses you can fight? 36. 36 fucking bosses without a replacement like Henry the previous game! Unfortunately, No More Heroes 3 also suffered the same treatment. I won't reveal how many bosses were killed, but I wish we have some replacement for them. As a fun fact, Suda51 said in a recent interview that those bosses were planned to have a proper fight, but were scrapped during the game's development. But if a miracle falls into No More Heroes 3's sales, we might get those fights as a DLC. How did Destroyman come back to life? This doesn't have an explanation by Suda51 like some other facts, but with the specific cutscenes, we can reach a conclusion about what, how, and who brings Destroyman back to life. After Travis finished him off in the first game, we didn't have the opportunity to see his corpse being burned to ashes. My theory is, Talbot and Weller take Destroyman's corpse to the UAA to start a new brand of assassins, which will be half person and half machine. This project failed thanks to Shinobu killing their creation, but they had another plan in mind. Somehow, they recovered Destroyman's memories and transferred it to a 100% machine Destroyman, and he started a mass production of himself to conquer the world. What a narcissist bastard! All of this theory came to my mind thanks to this specific cutscene. Sylvia is the current representative of the UAA. She has the freedom to do whatever she wants with no limits to stop her. In this cutscene, a specific boss got leg-shaked, but not having a fight is against the UAA's rules. That is why Sylvia activates an underground elevator to bring the first mass-produced Destroyman to the city to replace the killed alien. Now the question is, why Destroyman and not any other boss? Maybe to piss Travis in every entry? I don't know, but I love seeing him coming back in every No More Heroes entry, to be honest. Black Dog. The Black Dog is the reincarnation of the Green Reaper. Every time you come across it, it will bring disgrace, pain, and death to everyone around you. In Batman Strikes Back, another visual novel in TSA, Batman came across this creature, causing his friend to die by an ambush and almost kill him. Every time you come across the creature, pray for the lives of your loved ones. Sylvia married Henry when she was a minor. During Travis and Henry's talk in No More Heroes 1 ending, he confesses he met Sylvia back in college and married her 10 years ago. You know what is the most disgusting part about this? No More Heroes 1's Henry has 27 years old and Sylvia has 24 years old. By using basic math, we can get the result that Henry had 17 and Sylvia 14 when they got married. Henry is so fucking disgusting. He deserves to be cancelled on Twitter.
What?
Nintendo spoiled Batman's death. Back on August 2nd, 2021, Nintendo dropped a new No More Heroes 3 trailer. To surprise to all of us, those sons of a bitches spoiled Batman's death at the very end of the trailer with this frame. After I realized Nintendo spoiled the death of an important character, I couldn't stop feeling bad for being so stupid to continue watching Nintendo's trailers. To the 51's death perspective. Before working as a game developer, Goichi Suda worked as an undertaking at the beginning of his adult career. His daily routine was to take care of dead people and see other people suffering through their loss. And that is how Suda51 changed his perspective about death through pain and sadness. This change of perspective is reflected in games such as Killer 7, No More Heroes, and especially Travis Tries Again, where death and suffering marks a character depending on their will. Phew! That was quite a long journey, but we finally reached the end of the first No More Heroes Iceberg on Europe. Now, what next? Well, depending on how many views both parts receive, I may create another iceberg with new facts about the series. I don't wanna be cocky, but making another No More Heroes iceberg is a piece of cake to me. If you like the series, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and activate the bell for future videos. The future of the No More Heroes iceberg depends on you, my friend. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye!